Welcome to the series on Azure Migrate, your free migration and modernization platform, which helps you move workloads in a consistent and secure manner to Azure. In this video, we will show you how to use the discovery data for estimating total cost of ownership, TCO, and group-dependent resources with tags for collocation. If you have watched the previous videos in the series, you must already be aware of how a typical migration journey is divided into stages of decide, plan, and execute. In this video, we will cover the decide phase of the migration journey of a customer using Azure Migrate tooling. Talking about the discovery capabilities, Azure Migrate helps you discover servers across different environments like VMware, Hyper-V, physical servers, or servers running on other public clouds like AWS or GCP. Azure Migrate also discovers workloads like databases and web applications running on the discovered servers. The discovery is completely agentless, and no agents are pushed to any servers in your environment. You can also visualize network dependencies gathered from discovered servers that can help you analyze and group interdependent servers into applications. As part of prerequisites, you need to ensure that you have created an Azure Migrate project and deployed an Azure Migrate appliance. You should have configured the appliance and initiated the discovery. As covered in prerequisites, you need to deploy an appliance based on the environment you are hosting in your data center. After configuring the appliance and providing server credentials to perform guest-based discovery, like software inventory and agentless dependency analysis, you can initiate discovery from appliance and then review the discovered inventory from your Migrate project. Let's move on to a project that I have already created for this demo, where I have already discovered the data estate that I intend to migrate. The new overview screen comes up, which helps me navigate through my migration journey in a structured manner. You can start by inspecting your inventory and fixing discovery issues, building a business case to understand the value of migration, creating assessments to plan your migration, and then finally execute and track your migration. At any point of time, you can seek help and support. Furthermore, the new table of contents helps you navigate discovered information, analysis reports, and track progress of migration or modernization. Here we have approximately 600 discovered workloads. To gather detailed information about your workloads, let's go to Inventory. Inventory helps you identify the infra, web, and data tiers of your applications covering Windows, Linux, and SQL servers, as well as installed software. You can view all your workloads in a single place, and you can also analyze workloads such as databases and web applications present in a server by simply expanding inline. By default, you see the hierarchical view of the inventory, but you can switch to the flat list view as well. You may also choose to view your infra, data, and app workloads separately. We have also added the capability for customers to export the complete inventory across different discovery sources with the details of your choice, such as a .csv or .xlsx file. Let's now look at one of the servers and understand more information about that server. I can see some basic information on the overview details, such as the hardware configurations, storage, and network information. You can also find more information on the software, roles, and features on that server by looking at the software inventory information. I can also see one web app active on this machine and the tags for department and environment for this server. The Issues tab shows if an error was encountered in any of the discovery features on this server. To understand and resolve all your issues and errors in a single place, we have got you covered with the Action Center capability. Users can understand more about errors and find resolutions by clicking on the error ID. You can also view the number of affected workloads by a particular error, the features which are being affected by the error, and which of the errors are most recent. Users can view these issues by affected workloads as well, where you can see all issues pertaining to a machine at a single place, thereby quickening the issue resolution process. In this video, we're bringing a new experience which can help you effortlessly organize discovered workloads into neatly defined applications with the power of tags. Tags are intended to help you categorize inventory efficiently, which is crucial for operations like filtering, creating scoped business case reports, assessment reports, and more. Although grouping workloads as applications are a key use case, you can use tags to indicate environments such as dev, test, or prod department, or teams such as finance, HR, etc. Let's focus on Parts Unlimited, an app that we want to analyze and migrate. Through the new experience, we can identify workloads that power the application. We see that it is a two-tier app, with the web tier based on .NET and the data tier based on SQL Server. Here, while we searched for parts named workloads, the view by default shows the associated workloads with those having names with the prefix parts. You can disable this slider to just see the searched workloads as well. We can now group the workloads together using the new tagging feature. Let's tag the workloads with application as Parts Unlimited so that we can ease our experience moving forward in the migration journey. Similarly, we can find the workloads running on Linux servers and powering AirSonic applications where the web tier is based on Java Tomcat and the data tier is based on MySQL. We can group these workloads, similar to how we did with Parts Unlimited, with a tag that helps us use the application group in rest of the migration journey. Let us now analyze the dependency data gathered by Azure Migrate for easy identification of your applications. In the new experience, Azure Migrate automatically enables gathering of dependency data from your servers. You can find the boundaries of a multi-tiered application like Parts Unlimited using Azure Migrate's dependency view so that no workload powering the application is left behind during migration. Let's review dependencies of one such server by clicking on View Dependencies. When you open the view for a server, you see dependencies for a time range that could be the last 24 hours, the last 7 days, 30 days, or even a custom date range. The view shows incoming and outgoing dependencies for the server you selected in inventory view. Further, you can view additional details for the servers, connections, and processes in the visualization. Here you can see essential details of the server along with its software inventory. When reviewing the dependencies, if you are unsure of the application hosted on the servers, software inventory can help in identifying the components of an application running on the servers, which together power an application. You can analyze the strength of connection to help you understand if the dependency is ephemeral or recurrent. You can identify dependent processes with their ports information and view relevant workload information. Here, you can clearly see that the strength of the connection is high and the .NET web app is connected to SQL Server via port 1433. Once you have reviewed the dependencies, you can also group the dependent servers by applying tags on these servers in line with the visualization. This is another way of identifying and tagging servers belonging to an application, such as Parts Unlimited. Now that you have reviewed your inventory, analyzed dependencies between your servers to create application groups, you can go ahead and analyze the ROI of moving these applications to Azure by building a business case and then continuing to plan the migration of your workloads using Azure Migrate. Thank you for watching this video.